What is up, guys? This is Moose Mike from Deadly Domination Gaming, and today I'm just going to do a little how-to video. Now, I don't know if this has happened to you guys, but it happened to me recently. Now, I have been trying to play a few games on my PS4. I've been having some issues getting the discs in, and if I do successfully get the discs in, sometimes I have issues getting them out. So I put two and two together, and I thought maybe it's the rollers in the PS4 and the disc drive that are causing the disc to not go in or come back out. So I decided to go ahead and do a little research. I went to Amazon and I found this little toolkit. Now, I believe it was originally made for the PS3, but I was told that it works for the PS4 just fine. Now, I don't have the link for that at the moment, but I will put it in the description as soon as I find it. But just go to Amazon.com and you can see a PS3 toolkit or PS4 toolkit. This thing was 10 bucks, very basic. It has four drivers in it. I'll go ahead and open that up. Just a little Velcro case here. There's four drivers in it. They're color-coded. You guys may have these in your regular toolkits at home or something like that. There's nothing really special about them. We have like two small little star-shaped keys and also two regular Phillips screwdrivers. I'm not exactly sure what the sizes of them are, but that's what they are. This is what you need basically to break a whole PlayStation 3 or 4 down, or these four screwdrivers. So we're gonna need these, and I also have a pair of basic needle nose pliers. We'll need these also just for one minor thing in the PS4. So basically I'm going to show you guys how to break this thing down. Now, I've already done it. I've already went ahead and fixed the rollers. That was the problem. But if you guys are having an issue with your PS4 not accepting discs, or if it is not ejecting discs properly, just go ahead and lift your PS4 up. Now, you won't hear this on mine, but give it a little shake. If you hear something rattling around in there, there is a very high chance that one of your rollers popped, or a little piece between your rollers popped, and I'll break this down and show you guys. But anyway, let's get to it. So this is actually very, very easy to do. Now, if you look on the back of mine, typically I have the first model PS4. I think the newer PS4s, not the PS4 Pro, but the one before the PS4 Pro that has the push button power and eject on the front, I think they don't have the screws here, but mine's the first edition, so I got three screws that we're going to have to take off. Now, if you guys have never done this before, there will be three stickers on the back. Now, I don't have these stickers anymore. Not exactly sure what happened, but I kept taking them off and putting them back on, so they kind of lost their adhesiveness. They don't stick anymore. So, but be careful, guys, because I have heard once you take these stickers off, if you have a warranty, it immediately voids it. So make sure that this is what you want to do. Make sure you want to fix it yourself. I'm not suggesting to do this. I'm just showing you how I did it. So take them stickers off, and then we'll go ahead and grab our smallest star key here that came with our kit. And this is pretty simple. Just the screws are really small. Just go ahead and pull them off. And that is exactly why I have my white sheet of paper, because I just dropped this screw in my carpet. So there's one of the screws. I'm just going to go ahead and pop that on the paper there. Take your next screw off and go ahead and pop that on the paper as well. Yeah, my carpet's a little shaggy. It's new, so it sticks up, and I can lose these screws very easily in it. So now that we have them three screws taken off, we have it dismounted. Now, all you have to do is just grab the sides of it. Just simply pop it up. It's real simple. So now we have the inside of our PS4 exposed. Now, this part right here is your disk drive. Now, as you can see, my PS4 has went through a lot. I need to get some air duster for this thing, obviously, but this is for nearly 4 years of non-stop gameplay. I've had this PS4 since the day that they were released in 2013, so yeah, it's been through some stuff, but it still works like a charm. Just had that minor little issue with the disk drive. Now, I do have three small children, so I have a feeling it was due to them jamming discs in this thing is what popped the rollers. But anyway, So we have here, to release this disc drive, we have a screw here. We have a screw here that's holding the Wi-Fi cable. That's holding the Wi-Fi cable in. We have this screw, and we have a screw over here. We're gonna take these three off, and then we'll go to the next step. So we're gonna use the same screwdriver that we used to take the back plate off. So go ahead and remove your screws. Just like that, pop them aside. Just like that, take your next one off. Pop that aside as well. Okay, now we have that dismantled. Now if you look here, that screw is also holding the Wi-Fi cable in. So now we're just gonna pull this off real gently, it comes right off. There's a little tab here that's holding it in. We're just gonna pop that out of there as well. Throw that Wi-Fi cable aside for a minute. Now, here's a part where you guys might wanna be careful. In the disk drive, you have this ribbon right here. We're gonna wanna take this off. We gotta dismount this from the disk drive. So you'll see this little plate right here that is holding the ribbon in. Just gently push down on that plate. Just grab your ribbon, pop it out. But make sure you're pushing down on that plate because it is fragile. It will break. So you don't want that to happen because then you'll have to replace this ribbon or the little plate that holds that ribbon in. So there you go. We got the ribbon out. Now, we have one more screw to get to pop this disk drive out. But first, this is where the needle nose pliers come into play. And I believe this is the only reason we need these needle nose pliers. As you guys can see right here, we have a wiring harness that is plugged in to the drive. Right there, it's a little difficult to see, but there's a piece of black electrical tape on that harness. We're gonna have to take our needle nose pliers and pop that out. So, very carefully, because you can also break these wires, just be very careful. I just grab the electrical tape there. Just give it a little tug, just help it out, pop it right out, okay? As you can see, this is free. We got that popped out. Okay, so now that we've got that out, we have one more screw down in here. Right down in there, you guys can see that screw? We're gonna go ahead and pop that out. That's right underneath of that wiring harness. So, go ahead and pull your screw out. Now I don't have magnetic screwdrivers, so I'm just gonna pull it out and just let it set there, okay? We got it unscrewed. You'll see two screws here. Make sure you unscrew the big screw at the bottom, not the one on the top, the one at the bottom. Now I got that free, so I'm gonna go ahead and just give this disk drive. Oh yes, and my apology, this is where one of our Phillips come into play. We have one up here, a screw up here. I'm gonna take that out too. I always forget about that. Okay, let's go ahead and take that screw out with your Phillips. Let's move this back, okay? Okay, so we're gonna pop that screw, put that aside as well. Now, we should be able just to take this drive, give it a little tug, comes right out, okay? Very simple. Flip that drive. So we have our drive, okay? We have our drive exposed. We just pulled that out. Okay, now, very simple. We're gonna use our smallest Phillips again. Yes, our smallest Phillips that comes with the kit. You're gonna see a screw here, a screw up here, and a screw over here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, up here. Okay, so we're just gonna simply just pop these screws out. And I actually do have a game in this drive. I do apologize for that. I forgot all about that, but that's okay. So we're gonna go ahead and pop these three screws. Something like that. And now once we do that, that should free this, okay? So you pop them three screws out. Go ahead and lift this up. Now, them gears did shift because I do have a game in here currently, but go ahead and pop your Black Ops 3 game out. That's actually what a game I've been playing for you guys, Zombies Chronicles, but pop that aside. You got your disk drive open, okay? Now, what I have to do is, because because I had a game in there, this little lip is up here. So this is basically a barrier to protect you from putting other games into the drive. So this lip is up. So if you guys had a game in here and this lip was up, take this little white piece right here. Just simply pull it back. Just like that. That'll free that to where that is opened again. Now, as you guys can see, mine is fixed. This roller piece right here did not look like this whenever I opened it the first time. So as you can see, everything is, the rollers are perfectly fine. They're good. But what I'm gonna do is break this down just a little bit. Basically, if you open your disk drive, it may look something like this, where this little white, and this is what I was talking about, how if you jiggle your PS4, you can hear something shaking around in there. Well, when I opened mine, it looked like this. So basically, you need this white piece here to connect these two rollers, so this roller can turn this roller as well, because this roller is not connected to a gear. It needs this roller to turn this, which is why you need the white piece. So let's pop that stuff out, just as if it was like broke down and I'm fixing it for the first time. So now this roller's okay. Now what I did was, these rollers tend to get nicked up and stuff. They're actually supposed to be a little bit sticky so they can pull that disc in and send it back out. So I went ahead and took a little alcohol, rubbing alcohol with a Q-tip, and just rub these rollers real good with it, just to clean them off a little bit. It actually worked pretty well. So if that happens, if you got a setup like this, just stuff laying in here, all you got to do is take your roller, put that aside for a minute, take this white piece here. That's going to be what you're going to do first. You're going to put it inside of this roller, okay? You want to just set it right inside of that roller to where it will jiggle a little bit, but you want to make sure it's secure in that roller. You can tell. You'll be able to feel that whenever it gets in there. Then you just take your other roller. Let me go ahead. Take your other roller. I lift this up just a little bit. Take your other roller. Pop it in there as well. Okay? That way they're connected. Oop. Okay, let's try that again. Take two. Okay. Take your roller. Put it in the pin. Make sure everything is connected, and then just go ahead and pop your roller back down in there. Make sure it snaps, and then you got, now how you can test this as well is, take this roller that's connected to the gear, jiggle that around, and it should move the whole mechanism. Everything should move, okay? And when it's like that, your problem's fixed. So this is 90% of the time, if your PS4 is not taking discs or ejecting discs, this is the problem. So get this fixed. As you can see, it's real simple. I just did it. It's very simple. I'm not any type of pro at this whatsoever. This was my first time doing this. So if I can do it, you guys can do it. Okay? So now I'm gonna leave the disc out. I don't even know why I had that in there in the first place. I do apologize for that. But we're gonna go ahead and put this mechanism back together, same way we took it apart. Now you got your top piece with your gears and everything on it. Some crazy stuff going on here. Now there is a little lip here. You need, and you can see here, a little divot. You need to just work that in there, first of all. Get that under that lip just like that, and then just give it a little jiggle, make sure everything snaps into place just like that. Take your screws, grab your Phillips, your small Phillips, take your screws, put them back in. This, I swear, it's harder, it takes me longer to put it back together than it takes me to take it apart. Okay, so put your screw, your three little small silver screws back in. Okay. Just like that. Sorry guys, I don't have the patience to deal with these little small things. It will take me a moment, probably. But get your three... These are the toughest little screws here to get back in. Anyway, okay. So we got these babies screwed back in there. Our mechanism's all put back together. Good. Our rollers are in properly. As you can see, right here. One roller here, one roller here. Just test them again when you get the unit back on. Make sure they're still connected together. That way you're not putting it back together and then you got to take it apart again. So, okay. So we go to our base here. Let's take that Wi-Fi thing back off there again. Take your drive, flip her upside down. Now be careful with this. You gotta take and make sure your ribbons and your cables are all out of the way. That way they're not getting stuck under there. Make sure your Wi-Fi cable's out of the way. Alrighty. Now you're gonna have two little ribbons here, or not ribbons, I'm sorry, little metal pieces here. You'll see one right there. You gotta make sure it's on the outside of the unit to where this disk drive will just sit right down in there and it should snap right in just like that. Okay, now we're gonna take our four screws, put our screws back in. We're gonna grab our small star key. You know, actually, after doing this part, or fixing my disk drive here, I actually didn't need I didn't need one of the Phillips and I didn't need one of the star keys. I just needed two screwdrivers total for this whole project. Now, make sure, guys, whenever you put your next screw in, make sure you got your Wi-Fi cable connected here. I know it's hard to see right there. That's the little black thing. Make sure that your Wi-Fi cable is pushed in there. And then go ahead and there's two little pieces right here. It'll just snap down right down in there. Now we're going to put our screw back in, just like that. Take your next screw over here, pop that in. I did want to mention, guys, too, the irony of this video is I'm actually taking this video on a PlayStation 4 camera with my other PS4 that I have. So, yes, unfortunately, it is the highest resolution camera I have in my house at the moment. So now you want to make sure you get this screw back down in here that was underneath that wiring harness that we had to pull to expose this screw. You want to make sure you get that screw back down in first before you reconnect that wiring harness. Okay, get that screw in there. Perfect, we got her down in there. Okay, make sure you don't have to, just make sure that, you know, you tighten them until they stop. Don't over tighten the screws. Okay, now here's your little wiring harness. Now this might be the most difficult part. It was for me anyway. You want to just take that with your needle nose, wiggle it around in there. You'll find it with your as you're pushing it, you'll find it in there. Just wiggle that little thing around there and just push it in there until it snaps. And after I get it guided in with my needle nose, I'll just take my fingernail and just push it in the rest of the way, because you want to be very careful with that wiring harness. Then you're going to go ahead and take your ribbon, pop this right in there until it snaps. Should hear it. Well, it wasn't really that loud, but you'll know when it's in. And then just give it a little wiggle to make sure it's in place. Okay? Now, you're going to take the back, or the bottom part of your PS4, and just take the front part of it first, put it over the Wi-Fi unit here, and just work it back, and it should snap. Like that. On each side, it should snap. And you're going to simply up, and see, there's where I forgot that screw again. Got to take this back off real quick. We got this little screw. I'm glad I looked at it before I put that back on, which goes in the front, right beside the Wi-Fi unit. Right here in this hole, you're going to put this screw back in. I always forget about that screw, and that's going to take your little Phillips. Just screw that back in. just like that. Screw right there beside the wiring harness. Alrighty, and now we're going to go ahead and take our top piece, pop that on just like that. Then we're going to take our three back screws right in here, grab our small star key right here, just screw them bad boys right back in there. Just like that. Number two. And number three. Now, guys, once you do this, put your stickers back on if you have them still, whatever. I don't anymore. But you got that everything back together. You got your disk drive fixed. Now, this is 99, I don't know about 99, but maybe 90% of the problem if your PS4 is not taking in discs or ejecting them. And sometimes it could be the problem if it's not even playing the discs, because if the roller is out, it may take the disc in, but it may not set the disc right, if you know what I mean. So if you're having an issue with that, give your PS4 a little wiggle. If you hear something jiggling around inside, chances are you need to fix that disc drive. So go ahead and order yourselves these come in handy, man. You can take the whole, you can dismantle the entire PS4 with these things. You can do anything with these, with a PS4, PS3, whatever. So get yourself a couple of these if you don't already have them. Check your disk drive out, make sure that that's not the problem. Again, I'm glad that that is the only problem with mine, because it was a very easy fix. And get yourself one of these cool decals too, man. Like, honest to God, they're so cool. I've had them for years. I wish I knew where my controller was, because I had the decals for the controllers too. But I've had this thing since I've had the PlayStation, and they haven't really lifted up too much yet, so they're pretty good shape. And this thing's been through a lot. Sony products are great. This is why I'm a PlayStation guy. But anyway, yeah, so guys, this is how you fix your disk drive on your rollers. So let me know what you guys think about this video in the comments. Let me know if you guys have any suggestions to me, is maybe another way faster way to fix it or something like that, but this is the only way I know how for now. I hope this helps you guys, and if you guys have any suggestions on other things you can do to fix your PS4s too, let me know. Mine's really dusty inside, as you guys clearly saw. I need to get some air duster and clean that out. So if you guys have any suggestions on how I can clean this bad boy out too, give it a nice little detail inside it out, let me know about that as well. But as for that, guys, I am Moose Mike from Deadly Domination Gaming. I got some more Black Ops stuff coming up for you guys too. Black Ops 3, The Zombie Chronicles. I promised you guys I was going to play some of that, some more of that, like Kino Dirtoten and stuff coming. Figure I'm going to do some more of these how-to videos too, so I'll be back with that as well. So guys, check me out at www.facebook.com/deadlydominationgaming. Give this video a like, subscribe to my channel. I got a lot more stuff coming for you guys in the future. And for now, guys, take it easy. This is Moose Mike from Deadly Domination Gaming, guys.